When I met you in the summer, to my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown. And we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so innocent now, but you lied so soon. When I met you in the summer, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
First things first, I'm the realest.
I'm so fancy. You already know I'm in the fast lane. From LA to Tokyo, I'm so fancy. Can't you taste this gold? Remember my name. Hot to blow.
Why you gotta be so rude? Don't you know I'm human too?
I need you, darling. Come on, set the tone. If you feel the falling, won't you let me?
Good morning, Hiland. I'm Kyle Gerber, and welcome to this year's first edition of Inside the Nest. I'd like to welcome everyone back to school, from the seniors starting their last year at Hiland to the seventh graders starting their first. I remember my first day of seventh grade and all the struggles that came along with going to a new school. Here's Garrett, who went out and asked people about the seventh graders this year.
With the start of a new school year underway, to most of us, it's not a big change. 1 year older, 1 year closer to graduation. This is nothing to most of us, as we see all the friendly faces of staff and student body. However, there is one group of students who are in a whole new world. Welcome to Hiland, 7th graders. Once you walk through those doors, you're no longer the big kids of elementary school, but now you're the little kids of Hiland. The mixture of fear and excitement of being at the next level of education is something all of us have experienced. The teachers and staff here at Hiland are here to support you and to make your transition from elementary school to middle school smoother and to make you feel comfortable. The teachers and staff do an excellent job here at Hiland, and I am positive that you will enjoy your times here at Hiland as I have mine. Now I'm going to ask teachers and staff here at Hiland how they plan for incoming 7th graders and how they make them feel welcome.
Hi, I'm Mr. Weigert. I'm here to answer a question about how I make 7th graders coming into the school feel welcome and how I prepare. A few things. I like to make them feel comfortable. I like to give them lots of interesting things to do and just reassure them that they'll fit right in and that everything will be okay.
How do I make 7th graders feel welcome? I try to be as nice as possible. It's tough, but that's what I do.
Something that we do for 7th graders so they're more familiar with the school when they first come is we do an orientation, and we also like to do something new, and this year we did a orientation of sorts where they could come in and look at their schedule, go through class to class, and that would help familiarize themselves. And we here in the office try to be very friendly and helpful to the kids so they feel more at home.
Friendly and helpful. That seems to be what everyone tries to be towards the new 7th graders. We're all here to help you through this journey and to make it a great one. This is Garrett Snow, reporting from Inside the Nest. Back to you, Kyle.
Thanks, Garrett. I'm sure they should get used to things pretty quickly. Now, I'm sure you guys all saw stuff trend on the internet this summer. And I'm sure you all know what the most popular was. That's right, the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. Here's Jeremy with more.
We've been going hard for too long. Too long. Can't get enough, what is you on? Yeah. Yeah. Really ain't nothing I could drop that. Drop that. Wake up in the morning, make it all okay. Day. It's nothing, no. Nothing to get it popping, wanna roll. Roll up, up and away, here we go. Yeah. Now Martin had a dream, I've been dreaming about gold. Yeah. Tell him I just wanna shine and I gotta let it show. Yeah. Show up on the scene, walk right through the door. Got it on repeat, it's my double up flow. Vibrate the whole building, name ringing through your phone. Wait until the smoke clears, can you see me through the fog? Fall back, it could go all bad.
Many of you have probably heard about the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. However, for those of you that don't know what it is, ALS stands for amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, otherwise known as Lou Gehrig's disease. I decided to go to the halls of Hiland and ask some people what they thought about it and whether or not they accepted the Ice Bucket Challenge. So Kendra, what do you think about the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge?
I think it is great.
Okay, Mr. Jones, so did you take the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge, and what do you think about it?
I did indeed take it. I had fun with it, and I think it's a great idea, actually, that it's been catching on across America, and it's raising money for a good cause, and it's a great thing to do for this horrible disease.
So, Rachel, did you take the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge?
Yeah.
And what did you think about it?
It was cold.
So, Krista, were you nominated for the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge?
Yes.
And did you take it?
No.
Why not?
I just didn't want to.
So, Doug, what do you think about the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge?
Seriously, I think this is a very chilling experience.
After hearing what the students of Hiland had to say about this, I felt inspired and thought I had to take the Ice Bucket Challenge myself.
And listen, I sit back with my brand new inventions. Ice, baby. Alright, stop, collaborate and listen. I sit back with my brand new inventions. Something grabs a hold of me tightly, flow like a hawk daily and nightly. Will it ever stop? Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll.
For more information on this terrible disease, or to donate, visit www.alsa.org. Back to you, Kyle.
Good job, Jeremy. That was impressive. Moving on from that now, fall sports are well underway, including soccer, volleyball, cross country, golf, and girls tennis. Here's Garrett with more on the soccer team and how their season's going.
With the Hiland boys soccer season underway, the Hawks are striving for success. They are currently playing very talented teams early in their season, they still aren't satisfied with their performance. Now I'm going to ask the players how they feel about the season and what they feel they can improve in.
I'm really excited for this season. I feel like that as a team we need to learn better tactics and be more dangerous offensively.
I feel that this will be a great season because we are great. Some things we could work on would probably be scoring more and better defense. Defense. It's all about defense.
I think we're a really great team this year, and one of the things that we need to work on is communication.
I think that we can make it far in tournaments, but we need to play hard.
This year I feel like we have a really good soccer team. I feel like we have a very good chance at getting to state. We have a lot of seniors, a lot of great leadership. We have a lot of talent. I think we can improve on, we can work on our tactics and our combining plays and just our decision making on the field, just so we can be a little smoother as a team and just get to our full potential at where we really should be. Right now we're not quite at our full potential, but I believe that we can get there with a lot of hard work and a lot of dedication.
I think our soccer team is going to be really successful this year. I think we'll make it far in the tournaments, probably to state. And I think that the one thing that we need to work on more is our communication skills.
Thanks guys for telling us what you think about the season. Now I, being on the team, I think that we are a good team as of right now, but we are on the verge of becoming a great team that will hopefully get us to that state level. Some key things that we need to work on to become that great team is that we need more energy throughout the whole 80 minutes of that game, and then we need to keep our composure no matter what. Also, I agree with the others that we need to have better communication on the field and that we need to have better tactics and create goal-scoring opportunities and to capitalize on those goal-scoring opportunities. Reporting from inside the nest, I'm Garrett Snow. Back to you, Kyle.
Thanks, Garrett, and best of luck to all fall sports teams. Lastly, before I go, I'll be posting all the Inside the Nest this school year on my YouTube channel. So if you miss any or want to see anything else we do in video class, you can find me there. Just search my name. Well, that's all I got for you, Hiland. From Garrett, Jeremy, and myself, have a great year, Hiland.